Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net, and I'm doing another video on African violets, and this time I'm going to be showing how to propagate them by taking a leaf cutting. And I'm going to be using a different kind of growing system. This I learned from a lady who was selling these at the green market one year. She uses a baby food jar, a little plastic cup, and they have wicks in them, so they are self-watering, which is very handy, especially if you go away a lot. You could use this with any kind of plant if you had a big enough container and a big enough wick. I'm not quite sure what she used for her wicking. I'm going to be using some lamp wick, like you would use in an oil lamp. We'll see if it works. I have to keep my eye on it. First thing you need to do is to get your cup. A plastic cup would be ideal, but since these are not going to be in these cups for very long, I'm just using a paper cup. And I'm making a hole in the bottom to put the wick through. So it has to be big enough. I'm just using a darning needle.
Could you use a pencil?
That might be too big. You could use a knife, the tip of a knife, and then stick your wick up inside there so that it comes up along the side. You don't want it to be sticking out because you don't want it to dry off, but that'll be enough. And then you need a baby food jar. The small ones are better.
And how did you get yours?
My husband put a notice up on Craigslist, and a very nice lady who had a whole bunch of them met us in a parking lot at a shopping mall, and we paid her for a couple of dozen baby food jars. Okay, so now I'm going to be mixing more vermiculite with some soil, because remember, I'm starting these from nothing, well, from a leaf. And you can, again, just start them in water, but if you just have them in water, they're going to develop water roots and not ground roots. All right, now let me show you how I would pick a leaf that I wanted to use as the propagating leaf. I'm not going to pick these down here. These are older. You can see the color of them is getting less intense. I don't want to take these because that would ruin the crown and the beauty of the plant. So I'm looking at possibly this one. It's not old, but it's not brand new and still It will have enough growing oomph in it to give me another plant. So I'm going to go in as far as I can. And I'm going to snip it off with as long a stem as I can. Okay? Then I'll take my wet medium and making sure my wick is in place. Enough soil in there. Make a hole and stick this leaf down. I do not want the actual leaf to be in the soil. I only want the stem of it to be in the soil. If you let the leaf rest in the soil, it will more likely rot and then you'll get nothing.
Now, is there a benefit to using a paper cup rather than plastic cup?
Plastic will last longer, but since I don't plan on them being in this for very long, I can use a paper cup. Okay, okay, then just take your water, fill it up to the shoulder. Right where it starts getting narrow. Make sure your wick is in there and not stuck up on the side. Oops, now I got some. And you can see that the wick is down in the water and it goes up the side. So it will keep itself watered, and then I just have to make sure that I keep enough water in the bottle. Bye for now.